to fund that kind of rapid response team.
Has that progressed?
Not sure at all. You can answer that.
Who's trying to stop the operation?
So you, Chair, so if I can just pick up on a few issues.
I've brought people in when I want to bring them. Do we actually have an answer to that?
Two things we asked to explore last time is the possibility to do that, the possibility to use the probation service. That's being explored. I'm just currently in preparation for the report today, work through that in terms of what the current contractual commitments we've got and how we can get around that. One of the ideas was using the response comes in to flights, if the request comes in, and in the broader council remit, if that's not stated as urgent, it then gets passed to possibly the Birkenhead committee, who say we do want to pick that up in a way of doing that. The expertise of Mark's world and how we can do that.
I think we've moved away from what originally caused us to concentrate our attentions on this, which was that the new contract, first of all, that it wasn't given to deal with areas that we were concerned with the child, that there were problems in some of the urban areas. But the other thing was there was no flexibility about it. So if something was dumped one day after the street view, it stayed there for 3 months, and that meant, and no matter what you did, you couldn't get officers. I'm not being too critical of officers, but you couldn't get a response. And in the end, I would say this is an issue for public health, which it clearly was. That's been the one I raised for you. But it was so common in Warsaw Pass, it's this lack of flexibility that was the issue. Now, the contract and all that, we actually did know that it was all being reduced, the amount of being reduced. I don't think we fully understood the impact of that. That's probably our fault. But the real problem was that there was a completely inflexible approach to what we would consider being exceptions, and that particularly is our wards.
Yeah, and that's why we discussed one project, which was then imaginatively extended to the probation service as well. I thought we agreed that some of them, which would actually go to the development trust that would employ young unemployed people, who would actually run this service, give them something on their CVs, but above all, given that we've been actually discussing this for 9 months now, would have moved, we hope, a large amount of rubbish being dumped in various areas of Birkenhead. So that's a sense of urgency about it. George, you want to say?
I just want to come back on a couple of your items from our convention. And this is not having proper officers, this is asking for a straight answer. Are we, at this present moment in time, operating a monthly clean of the entrance?
Yeah.
As of today, are we operating?
With your permission, Chair, yes we are.
I spoke to one of your officers this morning, and I rang about my own entry, right, back at my house, and he said, you realise you're on a 3 month contract? I said, no, we're not. On a monthly contract. So I think in some ways we need to tell the staff as well that it isn't working properly. I did ask Doug this morning, would you get me a left press with one of your managers as well? I wanted to see a breakdown of when Shamrock and Wirral are clean. I've been told that it's on a Friday, but I'll wait till Friday. But at this present moment in time, I'm not seeing any cleansing taking place at that entrance. And one of the staff has told me the other day that Shamrock and Primrose is the worst entrance that they do in the whole area. Now, if that's the case, I just want to know the first part, why? And I suppose the second thing is because we're now 4 months into this contract, it should be from April, from the money into the budget. And therefore, I'm just wondering, can we have some guarantees from this meeting to the public as well that those areas will be identified, and they should be identified on the council website so that people can see when their entrance are going to be cleared. So if mine's going to be a Friday and it's going to be the fourth Friday of every month, at that time.
That's enough. Right. Look, what we want, when did this extra money contract start?
Through you, Chair, it's putting money into the existing contract that we have with.
No, but it was to improve the service. So when did the improved service start? Back entrance.
The funding was from the first of April.
So we should have seen the difference.
Sorry, I just wanted to make...
Are we actually on this business?
Yes, on this business. Earlier you were talking about your frustrations at seeing the contract, and I just wanted to make two points I hope were helpful. At the moment, during the audit period, any member of the public can request to go in and view the contract and request a copy if they so wish. The second point I wanted to make was, earlier in the year, the government came out with a transparency code, and by November, all contracts Wirral Council has will have to be published. So by November, all the contracts, including the Biffa one, will be published by the council. So I just thought that would be helpful.
But we also want contracts which are readable for us. Don't go back. First at the back. Sorry? Do you have a question?
We,
yes.
So why is there more capable? Because when we enter the building at all, we don't have to take a building through the net, putting out the pavement to the valley and bring it back. But there's anything hanging around, we won't be able
to. Question?
Yeah, just to go back on this enhanced provision and the cost of it, what I've thought about the fact that the cost of the pay is £7,000 would be way. I'm not getting the benefit. If this is something that the committee will be asked to decide on, and I'm hearing £40k left in the pot, £37k for cleaning the streets, is that's what I'm seeing. Am I misunderstanding something on that?
We've got in a sense many of you coming forward. People have noticed since signing the contract any improvements. And then one councillor questioned, well, what about my back entrance? And I'm being told, look, So the universality of the service is clearly not working as it should be. But there was also the question you raised earlier on, which is about fly tipping, not just in the back entrance, but on private land. Now, could we actually ask Mark, how does the council respond when it doesn't think it's in public land?
Through you, Chair, for non-highway areas, so areas of private land, when we receive reports of problems, we'd investigate the issue. We'd then look to try and establish who the landowner is, and we'd serve notice on the landowner if we know who they are to actually take action and actually get the land cleared up. Once we've got the name and we know who the landowner is, the council does have, by law, can actually take action and actually put a charge against the landowner of the property.
But Mark, according to the land registry, isn't it all land registry? Yeah, I've got large tracts of Birkenhead, which are private, which we don't know publicly yet, which we don't know who the owner is.
That's
not yes. That's different from some of the areas which are private areas where you see rubbish.
Through you, Chair, though it's a very difficult issue. There are lots of areas where we don't have the land registry records. If we've got the resources, and obviously that's one of the things the committee might wish to put resources into, we can then have the people to actually do the chasing or collecting the intelligence, knocking on doors, trying to actually track down who these people. It can be a very time consuming process to get those details to enable us to take them towards protection.
Yes, it would be so terrible, you'd never take a horse for that.
And look at all that reason, just wondering, if you do complain about special building materials, they'll take away perhaps old rubbish. But if anyone's left bricks, stones, anything to do with building materials, say the plant or something like that, wood, anything to do with building materials, they just have to stay in the
entry. Very quickly, I've done cases where people by navigators have dumped and said to residents, well, there must be something on this block, and they don't want to get the letter. Because my second question would be, and handy builders have done work.
They do it all the time. They work with the council.
Because we can't do everything at once, every culprit in this, I want to get to the stage where we're taking some action, some effective action, even if we have to improve it later on. Yes.
We had a lot of more materials in the metro. Now I've got to say,
put extra money in improvements. There clearly isn't improvement enough given what we've been witnessing around Birkenhead, particularly in areas where it's a twilight zone. Is it public or is it private? How does this relate to the project you wanted 9 months ago, which we gave you some money for? How would that help you now operate on that contract or that decision?
Well, I mean, service which we call the universal value. So, and I know there's Yes, there's not an issue with regards to looking to achieve that outcome, providing obviously consistent with the contract procedures and inviting the organisations that you'd like to be invited. That we need to give some consideration as to exclusively whether that's possible or that's carrying the organisation or whether in order to demonstrate that you really need to improve in this place. You can't be specific in terms of a specification around encouraging those who are going to bid or quote before you proposal with regards to employment and watch options. We need to consider the implications of that in terms of whether or not they're able to proceed to that, but that was part and parcel of the information.
Say that the opposite. We've got a clear steer from this committee. Is anybody against the scope of the scheme that I've described and fully described, the money involved and its urgency? Is anyone against the committee? Might we therefore say from this committee to the we would like to see this completed by we might wish to do other things, we might wish to come back, but we would like actually, before a whole year elapses, we have to actually ask them for something, we can actually ask.
Can I just ask,
Stuart,
just ask that, because I don't mind if we can get an easy, like 6 months, forget what happened 6 months ago, but I have a clear recollection of George sitting possibly in that exact spot. Moving
exactly
so
the same.
Words,
yeah.
Quite formally.
Mm.
Right.
I can say it pretty much been sitting right next to Molly didn't. I haven't got the previous minutes going back that far, but what has been the delay that since that decision was taken or George moved that resolution and everybody nodded? I thought at that point we were going to ask for expressions of interest, quotations in surveys. I take it from the conversation that's going on at the top table, absolutely no progress has been made on contacting any groups to express any sort of interest. Is that the case? I just wondered why that would be.
I do remember going to a meeting to say that I'm not saying we told John that it wasn't going to go ahead. It never referenced it back.
When they come, you know, I'm happy to take the saving for the 12 weekly street sweeping in these appropriate areas, well, we've not been seeing any difference particularly, you know. But if there's incidents of lighting, we need either bit that or our people to be at. Now, is this the area that's going to get Frank in the dock? Well, right behind the Frank in the dock. Is this the area that's going to put Frank in the dock? That we're getting litter removed within the 3 months, where Biffle will say, well, we would have done that if you had asked us.
The idea of Biffle in announcing on the land of the world, just we're trying to actually add to what they do. We're not taking any money away from them, so I mean, they'll still get their limits. We just want to improve the service. Now, I'm really anxious. We're 25 minutes out of time, shows the enthusiasm for this. Two questions, I'm going to ask Martin, and I'm going to get a further question. Pauline, first.
It's really about possibly private landlords and rented properties, because it's quite confusing, so if you're moving into a new area, to work out what put in what bin, and if there's nothing in the house in real life, unless somebody tells you, you don't know. And we've had people in our street and move in and out, and they never get the bins right, and they've moved on, and the bins have been there for about 12 weeks. But, you know, is there any way of using perhaps the agents that let these properties to have some kind of, you know, the council to give out what they can put into the bin, so that when people move in, you know, it must be somebody's responsibility when you let the property to tell them how to dispose of their
property. We will try. There is an association of land. Let's, George, would you put this to? All right. Last question then, literally, we need to draw to a conclusion.
Just the earlier comment to me about platforms, and I think these are Appendix 1 of the section we talked about makes reference to £37,000 of additional services. I was trying to understand, is that a proposal that the committee is supposed to be considering, the £37,000 of enhanced service they can purchase out of the £40,000 remaining in the budget? Just as a quick observation as well, all this talk about contract compliance, etc., etc. If there is already a contract in place with a social enterprise that provides the type of service the committee is looking for, why would there be any sort of competition issues in just improving that existing
contract in place with such an
enterprise? So,
yeah.
So what happens to that? Because it used to exist, but so I'm showing a little link today. I'm just trying to see, all the observation is you need to cut through some of the rubbish.
Our real problem is we made the decision over 20k service, that is the wish of the committee. Mark, why can this not mount the act of a law? Very quickly. Yeah?
I think.
Mark, back to Mark.
Through you, Chair, I think we can use the 20,000 in a productive way.
Sorry, in a way the committee is asking to be used. I'm quite sure
if the committee wishes to use additional resources for areas such as private land, it is obviously it can obviously look to divert resources into initiatives such as that. The issue that we have is that we actually have a contract in place with BIFA, which is supposed to cover all of our adopted highways. So if I'm sat before you, you know, as a committee trying to ensure that you're getting added value from the money, my advice to you would be to work with officers to make sure that the BIFA contract is doing what it should be. My understanding is that as part of these changes, there is a reactive neighbourhood committee aligned resource to deal with things like flighting. So if the advice today is that some of those, you know, that isn't working, we need to take that away and actually have a look at. You know, we are 2 months into a 2-year journey here. Some of this is really work in progress. So my advice to the committee would be, as officers, we will look to make sure that BIFA contract works for the adopted highway. And my advice to the committee would be to add value and actually deploy extra resources in areas where the council doesn't have mainstream resources and can really make a difference and do something that wouldn't normally happen.
I also think, this is the last point, I hope we're going to agree something. The very good. We're all agree that we don't want that the wish of the committee is not actually find reasons why we can't do it. We want that we want we want officers to help us do it quickly. Alright? Very good. Can I agree?
Can I just add,
though,
Chair?
Yes.
This is not the long-term solution. We need to educate people to be responsible for their own
buildings. The council is operating a number of levels.